From its humble beginnings in a Southern California health club back in 1983, you're about to see an exciting performance sport that is taking the world by storm. This is the event that started it all. From Los Angeles, the 1997 United States National Aerobic Championship. System home exercise videos. You'll love working out with a champion. Don't you dare touch that dial. Straight ahead, all the action of the women's individual competition. I'm Brian Drever. We're coming to you from Los Angeles, site of the most prestigious event in the world of fitness, the 1997 United States National Aerobic Championship. Tonight you'll be seeing all of the exciting elite events that you've come to expect over the last 14 years, along with competitions for masters, novices, and a first look at the National Aerobic Championship Club Cup. Coming up to lead it off, the individual women's event, but first, a quick word about the judging. Athletes will be judged using the 10-point scoring system similar to gymnastics, figure skating, and other Olympic events. Athletes receive up to 4 points for technical merit, 4 for artistic merit, and up to 2 points for degree of difficulty. Preliminaries were held earlier to determine the top 3 scorers in each event. Let's take a look at the results and see who will be going for the gold, silver, and bronze in the women's event. 5th place went to newcomer Californian Hina Allen, precise and controlled with solid showmanship. 4th was awarded to Miami's Janine Esquerri, who chose a high degree of difficulty routine to showcase her athletic skill. And that leaves these 3 to go for the medals. Surprising with her strength and grace, this Stanford graduate brings a modern dance background to the national finals in just her 2nd year of competition from San Francisco, Alexis Turner. Theater from Stanford. She obviously has a sense for the dramatic. Finishing with a one-hand press. She threw in a couple of rotating presses during her routine. Nice work by Alexis Turner.
Ladies and gentlemen, the scores for Alexis Turner in technical merit, 2.13. Artistic merit, 2.18. Degree of difficulty, 1.40. There were no deductions. Total score, 5.71.
Runner-up to two different champions the last 2 years, this sport aerobic athlete has visions of nothing but gold this time. A 10-year veteran and a real favorite to take the title, Phoenix, Arizona's Patricia Jasinski. Balance moves very nicely. And a very dramatic ending for Patricia Jasinski, a gold medal in her future. We'll have to wait and see.
The scores for Patricia Jasinski in technical merit, 2.50. Artistic merit, 2.40. Degree of difficulty, 1.42. Deductions, 0. Total score, 6.32.
Eleven years ago, she was dancing with the New Jersey Ballet, but for the next 2 minutes, she will be prima ballerina in a one-woman show here on the national championship stage. From Aramis, California, number one, going into these finals, Kathleen Riley. There. Trouble on that 360 rotating press, but a high degree of difficulty move. Finishing with a press to show off her strength, her grace, great extension on the high kicks. Kathleen Riley ranked number one. Let's see if she stays there.
The scores for Kathleen Riley in technical merit, 2.23. Artistic merit, 2.30. Degree of difficulty, 1.50. Deductions, 0. Total score, 6.03. Ladies and gentlemen, with a score of 6.32, the gold medal and the National Aerobic Championship goes to Patricia Jasinski. The silver medal is awarded to Kathleen Riley. The bronze medal goes to Alexis Turner. Ladies and gentlemen, here are your National Aerobic Champions in the women's division.
Still ahead in the 14th Annual National Aerobic Championship, the final in the men's individual and the tri-team events. Coming up next, mixed pairs. Let's take a quick look at the preliminaries and see who's advancing to the finals in the mixed pairs event. Fifth place went to Los Angeles, California's Basardi and Shar, whose potential showed in their interesting and stylish choreography. While the fourth place pair of Gary and Meredith from Chicago matched up well in their first outing together. That leaves these three pairs to go for gold, silver, and bronze. A former Worlds competitor who just had her first child a year ago has returned to compete with her coach and choreographer, who is also her husband. Proud new parents, Kim and Robert Terry from Kensington, Maryland.
Sweet dreams of rhythm and dancing, sweet dreams of passion through the night. Get into motion and meditation, so I can make it through the night.
Danced together, they have competed individually. This is the first time they have competed as a pair.
Yeah, this group more feeling.
Nice. Nicely paced and very well performed, Kim and Robert Terry.
Ladies and gentlemen, the scores for Kim and Robert Terry in technical merit, 2.35. Artistic merit, 2.20. Degree of difficulty, 1.10. Deductions, 0. Total score, 5.65.
Originally from France, she has competed as an individual. He competed as far back as 10 years ago on a silver medal winning tri-team. They're together as a mixed pair for the first time. From Pasadena and Glendale, California, Sylviane Chapelot and Robert Brady.
Thank you.
people have been saying potential about these two. They have realized a lot of potential already here this week and already in this routine. Clean. Impressive. Nicely done. Virtually error-free. Nothing to lose. These two look good.
The scores for Sylviane Chapuleau and Robert Brady in technical merit, 2.50. Artistic merit, 2.40. Degree of difficulty, 1.29. Deductions, 0.10. Total score, 6.09.
Back with a totally new look this year and going for an unprecedented third straight title. The defending champs stand out from the rest now in more ways than one. From Palm Harbor in the Tampa Bay area, Grant and Sandy Brazier in their alter egos as Brent and Mandy. Grant is saying, no more Mr. Nice Guy. They've not only changed their look, they've changed their routine. But it is interesting that Grant has gone with a bare midriff look for the first time, and they've both dyed their hair black. And they are as good as anyone has ever been at this event. Need I say more? Husband and wife, a working partnership. Boy, is it working. Sandy and Grant Brazier just might have made it 3 in a row.
Ladies and gentlemen, the scores for Sandy and Grant Brazier in technical merit, 2.78. Artistic merit, 2.75. Degree of difficulty, 1.27. Deductions, 0.20. Total score, 6.60. Ladies and gentlemen, with a score of 6.60, once again, the gold medal goes to Sandy and Grant Brazier, United States National Aerobic Mixed Pair Champions. The silver medal is awarded to Sylviane Chapoulot and Robert Brady. The bronze medal goes to Kim and Robert Terry. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, here they are, U.S. National Aerobic Champions in the Mixed Pairs Division.
Stay tuned for a lot more excitement from the 1997 National Aerobic Championship. Still ahead, the tri-team, novice, and masters events. Up next, the men's individual finals and a first look at an exciting new entry-level competition innovated by the National Aerobic Championship.
All right. Mark's right here. Hey, hey, hey.
During the past year, fitness clubs across America opened their doors to sport aerobics by hosting an NAC Club Cup competition. Thousands of aerobic enthusiasts took part in these Follow the Instructor competitions for the opportunity to come to Los Angeles to vie for the national title and to bring home the prestigious Club Cup. Based on their overall strength, flexibility, coordination, and ability to follow the lead of the instructor, the finalists were narrowed down to the best five athletes, including Jason Gavia,
Pasadena, California, Ballytoll Fitness,
Patrick Johnson,
your nation's capital, Washington, D.C., the Washington Sports Club,
Lois Miller,
Chicago, Illinois, the Chicago Sweatshop,
representing Fitness Elite for Women in San Marcos, California, Lori Pass, and Tracy Thompson.
Pasadena, California, Bodies in Motion.
Well, you know, we have clubs all across America that have registered to be part of the Club Cup competition. Any club across America can be involved in the National Aerobic Championship Club Cup. It's just a simple registration form, and we're there producing the event with them. Instructors, enthusiasts, club members, everybody takes part in the Club Cup.
I've been teaching aerobics, and we had the open competition in Washington, D.C., and I won first place, and so I'm here. And
people who ask all the time, how do I get started in the sport? It's the Club Cup. It's where you go from here that counts.
Anyone can enter Club Cup competition. If you basically can dance and have fun and just follow the leader, anyone can do it.
And hopefully they'll keep their interest and they'll go right up through the national championships.
The gold medal in the first National Club Cup Championship goes to Tracy Thompson.
The winner, aerobic instructor Tracy Thompson, will proudly display her NAC Club Cup at Bodies in Motion in Los Angeles.
Maybe next year I'll be competing in individuals.
It's on board, honey.
The fun and the challenge of the NAC Club Cup is catching on in fitness clubs everywhere. If you'd like to have an NAC Club Cup competition in your club, contact the NAC headquarters for information and registration materials. Now don't go anywhere, you won't want to miss the men's individual finals and the tri-team event when the 1997 United States National Aerobic Championship continues. Welcome back, everybody. Semi-finals were also held earlier to determine the three athletes who would be advancing to these men's individual finals. Dynamic and precise execution put Fort Lauderdale's Alan Nicholas David into fifth spot overall, while Chicago's Chris Fritzler showed excellent execution of difficulty elements in capturing fourth. And that leaves the medals to go to these three men. Southern California is where he's from, but South Florida has been a second home. Now, it seems the top three men have been training together, so let's say that all the cards are on the table, and let's see if Don Hostler has the winning hand. Best athletes in the country train together. They obviously push each other to new heights, it shows.
Stop. unusual push-ups there from Don Hostler. Strength and flexibility, and now back to the aerobic content. Well, the gauntlet is down. Don Hostler just might have set the mark to beat.
The score for Don Hostler in technical merit, 2.45. Artistic merit, 2.10. Degree of difficulty, 1.46. Deductions, 0.20. Total score, 5.81.
A gymnast and cheerleader who, like many with a similar background, has put in a boatload of work to become more flexible and improve his range of motion. And he's done that well enough to be a contender. From Queens, New York, Ken Berkeley. Another one of the South Florida training trio. Traveled and competed this year. Won in Puerto Rico. Eighth in Italy, sixth in Germany in international competitions. Whoa. Double whoa. We can say that Ken Berkeley just raised that bar a little bit higher.
The scores for Ken Berkeley in technical merit, 2.43. Artistic merit, 2.25. Degree of difficulty, 1.08. Deductions, 0. Total score, 5.76.
This man represented the United States at the World Championships last year, but this year the world came to him. His top two rivals have been living in Miami, training and traveling with the man with one name. The top scorer from the semis, here's Renzo. Hey! For these top men competitors that have all been training together, there are no secrets. They know what each other's got. the one that puts it out there the best is going to be the champion. It's as simple as that. Hey! This is the man they look up to, though. He's got to deliver. So far, he's doing a good job. Renzo was the king of the mountain. He sure didn't show any weakness in his routine or the execution of it. Now we just have to wait for the judges to see who's going to be the champion.
The scores for Renzo in technical merit, 2.70. Artistic merit, 2.33. Degree of difficulty, 1.40. Deductions, 0. Total score, 6.43. Ladies and gentlemen, with a score of 6.43, the gold medal goes to Renzo, United States men's champion. The silver medal goes to Don Hustler. The bronze medal goes to Ken Berkeley. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the United States national aerobic champion, the men's division.
When the 1997 U.S. National Aerobic Championship continues, we'll be back with the tri-team finals and a look at the winner of the Masters and Class 2 Novice events. Welcome back to the 1997 National Aerobic Championship and the tri-team competition. Here are the standings coming into the final round. The team of Miller, Baugh, and Sterling from Milwaukee had good interaction and use of the stage area to finish fourth. Three teams will now go for the gold, silver, and bronze. Coached by former team champion Johnny Underwood here for the last few days, this team from Wichita, Kansas has fine-tuned their routine right into the finals. Nikki Smith, Kristen Wehner, and Teresa Rudy. Wondering, that's Nikki Smith with the tattoo of an elephant. She likes elephants. Changing their formation well. Kristen Wehner in the center is on her way to becoming a pilot. Good work by these three from the heartland. Let's see how the judges scored them. There's the coach.
The technical merit score, 2.02. Artistic merit, 1.95. Degree of difficulty, 0.98. Deductions, 0. Total score, 4.95.
...1994 national champ Patrick Knowles now coaches his former partner Victor Finley Brown and new teammates Argentinian Jorge Del Busto and architect Vince Avalone. They scored big in the semis and are real favorites to challenge the defending champions.
The show with added music power.
Real power and presence marks this team's stage persona. That's Vince on the left. He was a champ camper just 2 years ago. Jorge in the middle. Victor Finley Brown on the right. Stage two. The red line marks out of bounds. If anybody's foot touches that red line, a foot fault will be scored and points deducted. They got close. They always do.
Come on, boy. Hey.
Crowd just having a little bit of trouble. That's the new guy, Vince Avalone, up on top. Let's go to the judges' scores.
In technical merit, 2.33. Artistic merit, 2.30. Degree of difficulty, 1.02. Deductions, 0.10. Ladies and gentlemen, total score 5.55.
It's not that often the champions return to defend their titles the following year with touring and all the commitments that winning brings, but these three just can't get enough of that wonderful stuff. From Tampa, Florida, the current champions, Heather Parker, Vicky Dumois, and Kelly Jakobach. Very complex pose to start their routine.
Too fair?
They are sharp. Heather on the left is Mary. Kelly, the smallest of the three.
I need a break, yo.
We made it through that move.
Hey!
Oh! Some real problems at the end, but boy, the champs were solid just about throughout that entire routine. Let's see how the judges score them.
In technical merit, 2.50. Yeah. Artistic merit, 2.45. Degree of difficulty, 1.31. Deductions, 0.50. Total score, 5.76. Ladies and gentlemen, with a score of 5.76, once again, the gold medal goes to Vicky Dumois, Heather Parker, and Kelly Jakobach. The silver medal goes to Vince Avalone, Jorge Del Busto, and Victor Finley Brown. The bronze medal goes to Kristen Wehner, Teresa Rudy, and Nikki Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the national aerobic champions in the National Aerobic Championship Team Division.
When we return, an inspiring look at the Masters and Class 2 winners. For the third straight year, the U.S. National Aerobic Championship featured the Masters division for athletes over age 35. This always proves to be a very popular and exciting spectator event. In the men's division, third place went to aerobic instructor Daryl Tisdale of Virginia Beach, Virginia. Second place to Noel Panjanivan, a systems engineer and personal trainer from Vallejo, California. And first place gold to John Machinsky, a lab technician and graphics designer who has been competing for 4 years now on a dare from his girlfriend. The women's Masters third place went to 48-year-old Donna Meyer, aerobic director for 24-hour fitness clubs. Second place to 46-year-old Nancy Severinsen, a production assistant and daughter of former Tonight Show bandleader Doc Severinsen. The gold medal went to the mere 38-year-old Pamela Maldonado, whose ex-pro football player husband coaches the former jazz dancer and mother from Petaluma, California. This year marks the introduction of the novice or Class 2 level athlete whose routines contain a more moderate level of difficulty. The results in Class 2 division were third place, San Francisco's Conrad Merriman, an aerobics instructor. Second to Jeff Johnson of San Antonio, Texas, also a fitness instructor as well as programmer analyst. Gold was won by San Diego's Ken Rosenthal, who somehow manages to work 60 hours a week as a small business administration loan officer while teaching a full load of aerobic classes and training another 20 hours for competition. The bronze for women went to Claudine Reese Fullman, a personal trainer from Forest Hills, New York. Silver to Santa Barbara, California group fitness director and personal trainer Dodie Benko. The golds went to New York City's Deidre Johnson, who began competing less than a year ago in aerobics as her first competitive sport. She's now perfect in her entire athletic career. How many can say that? Coming up next, all of that world-class sweat pays off, so stay with us. The 1997 United States National Aerobic Championship has been brought to you by the NAC System Home Exercise Videos. You'll love working out with a champion.
Continental Airlines, now among the best in the business at getting you to your destination on time.
Next time you're going to LAX, drive into the Wyndham. Our park and fly package gives you a newly renovated guest room and up to 7 days of parking for just $119 plus tax. Our 24-hour-a-day complimentary shuttle service will get you to your flight on time every time. Budget Rent-A-Car is pleased to be a sponsor of the National Aerobic Championship. Budget, great cars, great rates, and convenient locations. Renting from Budget makes all the difference in the world. After a hard workout, we recommend plenty of water. Come to Club Med. It's life as it should be. The fun and the challenge of the NAC Club Cup is catching on in fitness clubs everywhere. If you'd like to have an NAC Club Cup competition in your club, contact the NAC headquarters for information and registration materials.
To the hundreds of athletes who have spent thousands of hours training, we stand humbled by their dedication. To the fortunate few going home with the gold, we offer our congratulations as we take one final look at the highlights of the 1997 United States National Aerobic Championship. A special thanks to director Bruce Bryan and the hardworking television crew. This is Brian Drever for them saying goodbye for now, and we hope that you'll join us later for the 8th Annual World Aerobic Championship.